All right, is everybody here? Well, welcome. This is kind of our thing, isn't it? Every Sunday, it's our Coffee with Conti Corvette vlog. Thanks for taking the time to join us. My name is Rick. If you're in real time watching this right now, good morning. Anytime that you're catching this video, thank you for doing so. If you don't get a chance to watch this whole vlog in one sitting, don't forget to come back and view it. We got like a lot of little clips today that I think you're gonna enjoy. But being this is Sunday, let's start off our vlog with a little blessing of some Corvettes. So I got this quick note from Nick in Maryland, and thanks for watching the channel. He says, Rick, I thought you might think this is pretty neat. A couple of friends and I had our Corvettes blessed recently at the church. So far, it's good for winning trophies after the blessing. Because I'm glad you're looking and feeling better. Glad I got you fooled. Nick in Maryland. Thanks for watching the channel. Here's the video. I think I am sweating. Well, you guys will see why here in a second. Nice and hot. You know, it really pumps me up that you guys look forward to this show specifically. I've got other vlogs coming up throughout the week, but our Sunday Coffee with Conti episodes is just fantastic that you look forward to this. So in the spirit of YouTube and kind of teasing for next week's show already, right up front before we even got started with this one, I'm just going to tell you, don't watch. Nope, you're not going to like me. You're going to watch if you watch that video, and I'm telling you not to. Like, wait a minute, dude, this is YouTube. You want us to watch, right? Nah, I don't think I want you to watch this one. I'm going to put it out there anyways. And you'll get done watching it and you'll go, what did I just watch? So don't watch. Ding, ding, ding. Now everybody's going to watch next weekend. A little reverse psychology working on you right there. Don't watch it. Okay, I'm going to watch. You can't have that. I want it. That's the human nature, man. Before we get started in today's episode, I got a lot of stuff I want to cover with you. Let's address last weekend's show. I had two goals going into that show, sharing a lot of those TV and internet ads, and the one was obvious from reading all those comments. Many of you have never seen a lot of those ads. My other goal was, is after you saw those, you got pumped up for Corvette again. And that was my goal, to get you excited seeing those ads you've never seen before, but getting you pumped up for Corvette again. I mean, those were really feel-good Chevrolet Corvette ads. We kind of need that where we are right now in the marketplace. You know what I mean? All right, fantastic. Thank you again, everybody, for watching that video. If you didn't see it, there'll be a link down below in the description, so check that out. That one, I assure you, won't disappoint. And before we get going today, one of my customers is also waiting for the C8. We sold him a Corvette Stingray back in 2014. He's got some roots here in Ohio and also down in Florida. I talked to Nick the other day, and he says, you know what, I didn't realize, because, you know, when he bought his car, we weren't doing YouTube at that point. And he was walking by his friend's garage or house or something like that, and he heard me in the background. His buddy was watching me. He goes, wait a minute, I know. That sounds like Rick. He calls me up and says, hey, man, I saw you on the TV. He goes, you know, you got a lot of fans down here in Florida. You can give us a little shout-out once in a while. All right. Hi, Nick. Appreciate the support, buddy. Looking forward to doing business with you again. Mouth is really dry. Okay, right up front, let's talk about what everybody's talking about. More C8 spy shots released of the interior for the 2020? We assume that it is going to be a 2020 mid-engine Corvette. Take a look at these pictures inside. These aren't new pictures. This is basically the same picture from a different angle that we saw before. And I know I said before that I wouldn't show these shots. At this point, I said, what the heck? I'm showing them. But here's that. It's just two quick shots. There's one of the reasons I want to show you these. Now, let me give you a disclaimer. These are not the finished product that you're looking at. These are still prototypes. This is still the same car. You know why I know it's the same car? Look, it still has the busted center console button. Now, here's the one reason I wanted to show these, because we were the very first ones on YouTube to come out and let you know there's two new model body codes for production build of 2020 Corvette. And they said Stingray on there. And I thought that was a little astonishing. And people said, well, maybe it's going to be a refresh because we already use Stingray. I don't think they would use Stingray on the mid-engine car. Well, right here, if you look at these pictures, there it is. There's Stingray right there in what would be called the waterfall. And it looks like, you know, the lighting on this picture is not that great, but looks like that area around there and on top either could be carbon fiber or could be some kind of an LED light. Very quite interesting there. And I want to thank John at carscoops.com for allowing us to use these pictures. There's a link to his original article down below in the description. And if you look at this interior, again, I said this before, I love the contour of the seat. We get a little better look at the seat now, and I think that's going to fit you better. It's going to fit a taller client. It's going to fit a larger client. It's going to fit any client in that seat very comfortably. And that's a question that's come up quite often. Is this car going to fit a taller guy? 6'5", 6'7", 8". I've had a lot of you folks come in and say, hey, I love the Corvette, but I get in there and I'm looking at the visor and I can't see out the car. Rick, can you take the visor out? Oh, I can't take the visor out. So there's people that want this car, just can't fit in the car. And I show them without being blurred this time because of what we mentioned with the body codes and the Stingray thing and all that kind of stuff. So as things develop, I think there's an announcement coming soon, we hope, sometime in the summertime. This leads into what, you know, we're in such a different time right now in this car. I mean, we're getting, yes, there's a new Corvette coming out, but this is going to change the history of car, the whole complexity of the car. And we're going to go into areas we've never been before. So why not promote it differently? And so far, it's been pretty much the same thing. You see the camel cars out there, everybody takes them, the spy shot, everybody goes crazy. Now, those shots that we saw of the interior, that's not a spy shot, man. You don't walk up to a C8 prototype car with the door open and get a picture off without being somebody. So either he's got some big ones or he's in big trouble or it's just a plant and they're keeping us talking. And I think, you know, from the delay stuff that we heard, I think it's a good sign seeing these cars out there right now because maybe the program is not as delayed as what we had thought. So this is great news. So that's a good segue. Let's talk about, and I mentioned it last week, a letter I sent to one of the General Motors Corvette executives about an idea I had to share to continue to promote this car in a different manner. I know they're on the road. I've not heard back from him. Usually he's pretty quick to reply. Sometimes he'll reply late at night. Not heard from him yet. That could be a good thing, because that means he could be considering it. And I hope that he does. Now, let's face it, I've got a great connection with you guys here in the Corvette community, and I take it serious. I do it with great pride and great passion. And going forward, you know, here's the idea. I'm not gonna read you the whole letter. At one point, maybe we will. I basically said, and I did a spoof of this 2 years ago, but I said, here, we get excited seeing the car out and about, and we take those spy shots or what have you, and it generates calls, text, email, internet promotion all over the place. I mean, that's a good thing. You want people talking positive about the car, but yet there's still some negativity out there. So I said, here, why don't you, let's drop our guard, all right? I've been doing this 24 years. I've got total respect for Chevrolet and the Corvette team. Here's what I want you to do. Put me in one of those prototype cars and I would film out over the windshield and out through the passenger window. That's it, and actually capture the reaction of how people really truly are excited for the next Corvette. Seeing that, I think, would just be astonishing, would be powerful, and just kind of keep that heartbeat going. It would be from a different angle, and from a guy that is truly enthusiastic and very serious about this car. I let him know in the ground rules, hey, I'm not gonna talk about how the car feels, how it sounds, we're not gonna put the driver on camera, we're not gonna talk to him, we're not gonna abuse any of that privilege, we're just gonna show out over the windshield, out through the passenger window, in my heart once I get these ideas, I really just want to do it. So I hope that they go, wow, this guy's really thinking outside the box. This is a great idea. What a different marketing angle. And then we would present it in a very professional manner, but show you guys how you guys are really truly reacting to this car. Many of you know, I mean, you chase these cars down, you follow them, you make these YouTube videos, there's internet articles all over the place. I want people to know that there is an excitement, there is a pulse for Corvette. And I want to capture that for you firsthand. So for the folks, and I know some of the guys at Chevy Watch, if you're watching, read the letter I sent to, okay, you know who. I'm sure he's talking to you guys. Let's find out. You know, I'll sign off any responsibility of my person in the car. Whatever I got to do, I just want to make this thing happen. So that was what I'd sent. Once I get a response, I'll let you know what they say. And I'm rambling again. Okay, so I really want to do this. Hey, let's move on with today's show and show you some of the great people that I get to deal with. All right, guys, I just walked into the office. This is sitting on my desk, and I figured I would open it with you right here in the vlog. Yep, it's from Austria. How about that? Oh, yeah, look at this. Oh, my gosh. Look at this. My Way. Can you guys see that? My Way. I love it. My Way Corvette Club, Austria. Oh my gosh, I'm an honorary member. Look at that. All right, let's check this letter out. Dear Rick, you know I'm a great fan of you and your vlog. Unfortunately, as you know, we don't have a Corvette dealership here in Austria. The next one is over in Germany. It's so hard for us to get good information about Corvette from them. I'm also the president of the My Way Corvette Club Austria. Therefore, I always post your info to our members. One of the best examples was the tech vlog you did. I always had a problem with that comfort entry. My seat didn't work on my manual C7 Corvette. After your vlog, I learned about the electronic brake. Even my dealership in Germany didn't know about that fact. So now it's working perfectly. What he's talking about, we were talking about the memory package. If you've got that system turned on when you get into your car and you want your seat to come back and steering column to come back into position, and when you turn the car off so everything goes backwards so you can get out, well, it's different if you've got a manual Corvette. You've got to have your emergency brake on first, and as long as you've got that stuff turned on in the settings, then everything will work. We'll put a card over here and we'll put a link down. Did I put my hand over my mouth? That was stupid. Put your hand over your mouth. Put a card over here. We'll put a link down below in the description if you've got a manual C7 and you want to know properly how to set and utilize your memory package. Check that vlog out. All right, let me continue this letter here from Emmanuel. Oh my gosh, this part's awesome. Listen, oh, check this out, you guys. We talked about you, Rick, at our year-end Christmas club meeting. The whole club voted unanimously, decided that you're going to be our first honorary member of the club. So here is your official shirt and your certificate. We'd also like to invite you, if you're ever in Europe, to stop by and get to know some of our Alp streets during our Dream Cruise event. Here's also a pic of part of our club at the Prague Corvette meeting. I hope you like it. Yours truly, Emmanuel. You see, there's part of the club right there. You know what, guys? As I'm sitting here thinking about your club name, and again, the shirt is just great quality. Every Corvette emblem ever made, all embroidered on there. Look how nice that is. But I'm thinking about your club name, My Way Corvette Club. Do you guys have a theme song? Here now is Mike and Michelle from Ohio. They recently took delivery of a 2019 Grand Sport at the National Corvette Museum. And they ordered their Corvette and they're getting ready to take delivery at the National Corvette Museum. So that's pretty cool. So I at least wanted to get them on the vlog and say hi and say thank you. This is their first ever Corvette. They got a shadow gray Corvette. This is pretty cool. And here's the other thing we talked about too. We talked about, you know, guys, we've been teasing. Guys, you know, do you order the 7-speed because, you know, the wife's not going to drive it? Do you order automatic because the wife will or won't drive it? Well, Mike went with the automatic and Michelle said, oh yeah, I'm driving it. Oh my gosh, it's great to have you guys here, have you on the vlog. You saw that one that I was just talking about. And I think it was the next day or so. I mean, you guys came up. I think it might
same
even.
Day.
No, it was the same day.
Same day.
It was the same day. You guys came up, and it was that was impactful to me that you saw that, because I've been trying so hard to be as transparent, you know, as everybody's in waiting for the C8. Yes, no, maybe so, and all that kind of stuff. But you know, ordering a 19, once it's over, you can't go backwards. Can't so go back. You guys got ahead of it. Yeah. You got yourself a shadow gray, beautiful Grand Sport.
Yeah, we're thrilled. You spent a couple hours with us that day and answered all our questions, and we rocked and rolled.
Well, you've been understanding, too, with my health situation, which I keep referring to for folks that are new to the channel that don't know. So working through that best I can. But all Michelle's right. Like, she goes, he might let me drive it around the neighborhood. I said, yeah, you better be driving it more than that.
I'm driving it more than that.
That a girl. I love it. That's fantastic. Well, it's good to share your experience. You got any friends and family going to be watching you guys back home on the webcams and stuff?
Oh, you bet. They got the link. Yeah. They're ready to go.
Do they? Yeah. I'm glad. I don't know when it was. It was a few years ago that they finally changed those out, and they've made them where they're, you know, higher resolution. Mm-hmm. It's just like being there. There's a little bit of a delay. It's like a 5-6 second delay. So you wave, and then you got to wait, and you got to sit there and wave. It's like, well, wait, just wait. My wave will come back up, and then you can screenshot it, you know?
Yeah.
So it'll be good.
All right.
You guys are in for a treat. They do a great job down there.
Looking forward to
Looking forward to it.
Yeah, fantastic. Just make sure you come back and see us.
You bet.
I appreciate your support of the YouTube channel. I appreciate your business. You guys have been awesome.
Thanks,
you've just been awesome.
Appreciate
so your
it.
First ever Corvette.
Yeah, we're excited, man.
I ask a lot of people this now lately, you know, because you're picking Corvette. People are curious that if you've had them in the past, but you know, what actually motivated you to decide on Corvette? Was there anything that just kind of said, hey, I want a Corvette? Or
yeah, I think we love the American-built car. It's
okay.
That's the iconic sports car of the USA. I think the thing that sold us is we actually went to the museum and toured it last summer.
Oh, okay.
We were there for something else. We toured it, and we just looked at each other and said, It's got to be a Corvette.
Hey gang, thanks for joining us on this edition of Sunday Coffee with Conti. Got a few send-off pats to share with you now. One is to Gary in Texas, where I was actually supposed to be this weekend. Sent a really nice email, talked about the hassle-free experience. Really appreciate your flexibility and your confidence. Congratulations.
Okay guys, I got my Corvette Ninja outfit on. Don't let that sun fool you. Wind chills in the single digits. Got this beautiful Elkhart Lake Blue car going to Gary in Texas. You know, and I love going to Texas. About this time right now, last year, I was getting ready to go to the Corvette Expo. I mean, I've been there 5 times in the last 7 years, and I'm kind of bummed that this year I'm not going to be down there for the Corvette Expo. Seeing all the folks from the Houston area, down in Galveston, you guys are absolutely awesome. Now, this particular car is going to North Richland Hills, Texas, if you guys know where that's at. Maybe you see Gary out and about sporting his beautiful. This has got the, it's got those blade accessory wheels. Yeah, yeah. Gary, thanks for the business. Thanks for the flexibility. Truck's out there waiting. Let's get in the car. Let's get you out there. There we go. Got to give Gary a little send-off pat. Send-off pat for Gary in Texas. Congratulations, man. Thank you again. All right, here we go, kids. So we just washed the car, and the engine's starting to get warm, so that's why you're seeing a little bit of steam coming out of the hood extractor vent. Looking good.
Equal both sides?
Yep. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, the wheel is going this way. I had to straighten the wheel out a little bit. And you look good. Good, that's about a foot. Heck of a lot easier than an automatic, isn't it? Touche.
It's really hard loading cars on a Saturday. I got people that are really understanding. They're in the finance office signing right now. I've got two cars, two used Z06s that are going to Washington State. But unfortunately, I'm sorry, one of them I can't do. Well, we're gonna try and do it anyways. We're gonna do something. The send-off pat outside the truck, because the driver was antsy, grabbed the car when I was with my guest in the office, and he's already loaded one of them. I'm going to get the other one right now. And it's just funny on how small the world is because of the internet. These two used Corvettes sold about a week from each other. They're gonna be 30 miles from each other. So I'm sure at some point these guys are gonna run into each other, you know, at an event, a gas station, grocery store, whatever the case may be. So that's good. So we're gonna give you one outside the truck send-off pat and one inside the truck. I guess I'm just a little nutty. I've got like a process that, you know, if I don't do something in my process, then it stresses me out. You know, if I don't put like the congratulations sign on your car, that'll like really upset me, because I do it all the time, and that's something I want to do. When you guys see your car, when it comes off the truck, or you come to the dealership, I want you to see your name on your Corvette. So, you know, this is the process that we're doing. Thanks to the truck driver, we're going back up. We'll do a little send-off pat for Mark. I'm getting confused. I got Mark and I got Mike, so I gotta make sure I'm talking about the right guy. So yeah, that is Mark's car, already loaded in the trailer. All right, so I'm gonna stand back here, because we did not get a chance to give. Yeah, no, I'm gonna do it side. I mean, Mark, I'm gonna give you a backhand, brother. Congratulations, Mark. Thanks, man. Appreciate the business. Enjoy it. It's neat that you guys live about 30 miles from each other. I know that you're gonna see each other. Beautiful 15 Z06, what a great opportunity for you. Thanks for the business opportunity and your flexibility to buy a car over 2,000 miles away, man. That is awesome, I really appreciate it. And I'm standing back here because you guys know I have to give you the traditional send-off pat to get your ownership started the right way. So here we go. Congratulations, Mike in Washington State. Appreciate it, man. Today's show, we talked about how I wasn't able to attend the Corvette Expo this weekend in Galveston. And that's some of the things I really love doing too, is representing this car, not just here at the dealership, but participating in different shows and events all across the country. Last year and many times over, I've had the opportunity to meet Dr. Davis from Louisville, Kentucky at the National Corvette Museum. He watches the channel, great supporter, I appreciate that. And all of a sudden he saw this beautiful Admiral Blue Grand Sport that we bought for extra inventory. He called me up and said, "Hey, Rick, I like that car. I'm coming up to get it."
got here sooner than I thought, so I wasn't prepared, but I promised I would take care of this request. So hang on. I was just telling the folks on the channel that I think it's a real treat and a pleasure when you guys watch me and then you come here to do business.
Yeah.
But you and I talked on the phone last night. Yeah, you made an odd request. And I said, ah, you know what? I'll take care of it.
What's that?
Dr. Davis said, he goes, you know, Rick, I do get paid $2,000 to make those YouTube appearances, so I want to take care of that up front so we're good. Yeah. We're able to move forward.
Yeah. My wallet's not big enough for this.
Look at that. Right. It's good to see you, man. Thank you so much.
Right.
It's always been a pleasure talking to you, seriously. And you got a great looking car.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Yeah, as a matter of fact,
good to meet you, brother.
I've not seen a dealership where, you know, there would be a Corvette that I would buy on the lot.
You know, because you order most of your stuff, right?
Yeah, I order it.
It's pretty neat. I was just getting ready to open the door and show folks.
I saw this and I would
it's beautiful.
Check it this way.
Look at that gray, how nice it looks with the Admiral Blue and the stripe. Mm-hmm. It's a 3LT. Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Just beautiful.
Yeah.
Just beautiful. It really is. I'm glad you made it here. And you got the ceramic brakes.
Yeah.
Yeah, buddy.
You know what's the good thing about those, other than the fact that they'll stop you every time, is they don't dust.
Right, they really don't.
They don't dust much. I know what I want when it comes to a Corvette, and that helps, you know.
Absolutely.
And plus seeing you on YouTube and,
thank you, man.
For, God, at least 2 or 3 years.
Yeah, you and I talked several months ago.
I talked to you down to Corvette.
Yeah, I saw you down at the Passion, different events.
My buddy.
Absolutely.
Down there.
Oh, it means a lot, man. I'm glad. Yeah, you did a quick flight. Now you're going to have a nice little drive home.
Before
he goes, Dr. Davis knows we're going to do a send-off, Pat, before he gets out of here, too.
Yeah. Do business with this man. He's good.
He's got $2,000 on him, so he's buying lunch for everybody.
Yep.
That's right. I love it.
I appreciate you hanging on to this till I could get it.
Oh, no problem. Thanks for the opportunity, man.
Sure.
It's great. It's really been nice talking to you, man. I'll tell you what.
Thanks a lot, man.
You're a blast. Congratulations.
All
right. He's going to hop in there, and he knows that we're going to do a little send-off, Pat.
Take care of that knack, too.
Yeah, I'm trying. I am.
Yeah.
Slow but sure.
Yeah.
I appreciate it, man. Congratulations, Doctor.
Thank you.
All right, Mike. Let's give him a little send-off, Pat. Get him going back to Louisville, Kentucky. Send off, Pat. All right, Dr. Davis.
See you later,
man. All right, man. I'll see you in a couple months.
Thanks a lot, man.
Thank you, man. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, guys, that's our show today. I really hope you enjoyed it so much. I just want to talk about something real personal here that I didn't want to dwell on, but I want to address it because we haven't talked about it in a while, and a lot of you have been real supportive. I mean, here's the thing. I mean, I don't have a life. I work and I go home and I do what I can for the family. But I mean, you guys are my social connection, and that's why, I don't know, I'm very comfortable with you guys here on the channel. That's why I'm compelled to share some of the personal things that I do. And I don't want to go into a big thing, but I did share some stuff on Instagram, on Facebook, talking about my personal issues. The neck issue is still being addressed. I knew I had a sugar issue. Now I have a major sugar issue. I mean, I'm drinking 15 plus of these things a day. I've stopped several times editing this video because my mouth goes completely dry and I can't even get a word out. Let me tell you guys, I'm really sorry for being behind, because when this all started occurring, there were several weeks that I just didn't even function like a normal person. I was trying to do emails. I'm leaning back in a chair, got an ice pack, arm just cruciating. I'm behind schedule, and we're approaching it. So there's a lot of people that I've not had an opportunity to reach. Believe me, I am not blatantly avoiding that email, that text message. I am truly nonstop all day long. And then I go through these just down energy spurts, sometimes taking a nap upstairs for 20 minutes, boom, I'm ready to go, trying to change my diet, what have you. And many of you understand that, but it frustrates me, stresses me out, man. I don't want to make anybody wait, so please understand that. Now, some of you don't understand that and haven't been very nice, so that's reality, man. And I'm sorry. I'm doing what I can. I do everything by myself. I get a lot of really, really bizarre requests, and I'm trying to channel those along with the orders that are coming in from people so I can get those facilitated. So I am committed to do all I can, as much as I can, to get back in the groove. Doing these YouTube videos in the middle of the night, that's part of my commitment, to stay communicating with you guys, connected with you guys. So I'm sorry for those that I've missed so far and have not replied in a timely manner. I'll be in the middle of typing something. Here comes somebody, comes in, this call comes in, and I got emails up, bing, 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 different things up, and I can't even finish those because it's a nonstop interruption all day long. What appears sometimes to be an emergency is not an emergency, but they take me out for 30 minutes, and man, I can get a lot done in 30 minutes, you know, and we're, you know, it's March right now, so we're not really into season yet here in Ohio, but as soon as that weather turns in April, we're going to be slammed with, you know, floor traffic here, and plus the internet business that's very huge for us. I'm trying to juggle everything, so just want to throw that out there. Thanks for your well wishes. I learned a lot. Chris, we talked the other day about diabetes and things like that. Man, I learned a lot. I'm actually standing up right now. He says, hey, man, you had a great idea because I do need to exercise more. He says, hey, well, you're taking a phone call, Rick. He goes, you already know your stuff. He goes, start doing a lap. Start walking around the lot. If the weather permits, get out there, walk. I'm committed to beat this thing, to manage this thing, whatever I got to do so I'm healthy, not just for myself and for my family, but for you guys. So thanks for that understanding. Thanks for, I don't want to talk about all that stuff. People don't want to hear that. They're like, man, I don't want to hear this Debbie Downer stuff. But I mean, you need to know the reality because of the connection that we have. So thanks for letting me just kind of vent and get that off my chest. I read all your comments. You guys on Instagram, here on the channel, on Facebook, it's very, very touching to me. And you guys, I look at as family. That's why I feel like I can share what I share and discuss what I discuss with you guys. So like we said, next week, don't watch. I'm telling you, you ain't gonna like it. Next week, don't watch the Sunday Coffee with Conti. But have a great day today. Thanks for watching this episode. I'll see you later. Subscribe to the channel. Thumbs up this video. Leave a comment down below. Thanks.